Hey guys, this is Harris Knight, and this is Let's Play Bioshock 2, where we're finally going into pretty much the last stages of the game. Well, we just left, Gail Alexander behind to just for dead. And now we got his little key thing we made out of his DNA, or however that works, in order to unlock this secret passage up here into the prison area of Rapture, where Sofia Lamb still rules from.
This is the Oxyfield station, Chief. But don't be fooled by the facade. This is the way in. Use that key now.
Yes, thank you, Sinclair. I mean, you pretty much told me that 2 or 3 times already. And here we are. Dr. Lamb knows she pretty much has nothing left to get to me with. There's really nothing left standing in the way.
Eleanor's condition may be a blessing in disguise. Early splicing tests indicate 0 genetic damage due to her condition as a little sister. It appears that she is our new vessel.
Is she also a skilled orator, as in being able to deceive people with pure and utter bullshit like you are? Just kind of makes you feel all that much more justified in being the one to come rescue her because her mother's a psycho. A well-meaning one, perhaps, but... Oh, and I kind of always liked this song right here, Daddy, Won't You Please Come Home. I think out of all the vocal songs on the soundtrack...
Persephone, we're finally here. Find Eleanor, son, and fast. Her mama's got all Rapture dying to keep you two apart.
Yep. I did say there's really nothing left in the way, but there's still plenty of splicers left alive in Rapture who I haven't fought through yet. And they're still all quite eager to do Dr. Lamb's bidding, but as of right now, she really doesn't have any more obstacles she intends to lay out in my path. She's pretty much right down this hall. And it's time to settle up this little custody battle over Eleanor. On my way, honey.
I wonder, Delta, do you know why you are here? Have you any idea what my daughter has given you?
Still salty,
as
huh?
I watch you now, I envy your ignorance. You still believe.
Yeah, she's salty. Okay, this is pretty much probably the last weapons upgrade station, so let's see. Huh. Really don't know what that is, but it sounds cool. So I'll take it. Now, just before I can actually get into the little chamber where Eleanor is held right now, which is on up ahead right here, Dr. Lamb does have one last nasty surprise for me. And we are not to take them lightly. It's two big sisters at once. Now, how she took control of them and was able to send them after me, I don't know. but a mother distraught at the thought of losing her child, even if for good reason. Really don't know what she's capable of at this point. One with her. Okay, now she's right there ahead, but
Eleanor Lamb.
We're gonna set down our perimeters first.
Feeling right now. This is business. Get that cage open. She's coming with us.
Pretty much as I intended all along. Okay, so there's still a few first aid kits in the room in case I need them. Eve hypo, drill fuel. Always gotta have that shotgun ammo. This probably still isn't near enough to take on the little sisters, but here we are. Should be able to buy the other kinds of weapons I intend to use here, defensively. Whoop! Oh, Proxmind. Proxmind? Yeah, sorry, Proxmind. So, Phosphorus Buck just never really seemed to hold the sisters at bay. Armor piercing rounds, anti-personnel. Trapped spears, hell no. Because if I intend to summon flying bots into battle with me, they're just going to stupidly run into them, render them ineffective. I don't mind a heat-seeking rocket or two, though, and we already have a full supply of mini-turrets, so that's good.
That tank she's in. Use the controls to break the quarantine seal.
Now, I don't remember where exactly they come from, but could easily be out of either door here. Let her step on a couple of those.
What are you waiting for, kid?
Oh, easy there, Sinclair. Now, I know in the game world we would normally be on borrowed time here because I think Dr. Lamb intends to just kill her own daughter just to spite me. But nevertheless, it's not gonna happen. Nothing's gonna happen until I'm ready. Yeah, no trap spears, I'm afraid. Now, Proxmines, it is really nice to be able to carry like 12. I think originally you could only do 6. All the other times I played this game, but after researching the Alpha Big Daddies enough, I got that pleasant little surprise of being able to carry more ammo. Definitely helpful. Okay, well, either way they come out, there's sure to be a decent amount of their health shaved off before they can get to me. You know, I would like try and make some use out of Inferno, but the insect swarm is just too good at keeping enemies busy. Now, the big sisters probably will barely even be affected by the actual Inferno, and I know insects won't do a lot of damage to them either, but it's bound to, you know, at least kind of hold them in place for a little bit. I think we're ready.
How will she remember us after this moment? I have placed my pieces.
Yeah, there's Eleanor.
As expected, as have you. Is this what she hoped for? Mother and father, locking eyes. Yet still we are blind. Goodbye, Subject Delta. And take heart, for you at least have escaped your legacy.
Here they come. Whoa, where's the other? Oh, they didn't come through either door. I think they came through the ceiling. Anti-personnel rounds, will that work? Well, while the other big sister's busy with the turrets. Okay, time to pick up some health kits. And we'll try out some grenades on them. Alright, she's almost out of here. Alright. Oh, the other one's dead.
Hurry now.
What got her?
Chambers waiting on you. Get in there.
Well, that went unusually well. How'd the other one die so quickly? Especially she didn't even...
What are you waiting for, kid?
Jeez, Sinclair, chill out. This isn't the end of the game. I gotta reclaim all the stuff I haven't used to fight against enemies later. Even now, Dr. Lamb still won't give up. Just watch. Have I looted their corpses yet? Kinda. Okay, here we go.
She wanted a father, so she found a way to restore you in body and mind.
I think Dr. Lamb also just hates men. Oh, you mean me and my acts of mercy? Unlike trying to kill people. Like a certain someone.
The girl lying on that bed is no longer my child, nor my life's work. She is a monster, shaped by you alone. Just as she has always...
Shaped by the evils of free will to do good. Oh, the horror. I tell you, Dr. Lamb is just... Of course, as we all know, though, the game is not going to end there on a bad note. Of course, she actually doesn't kill Eleanor, and of course, that doesn't destroy me like she... Like she would have been smart to do.
Full restraint at all times. No one enters this room until he expires.
But I don't expire. Do you think that once I have air back that I'm just going to die anyway?
It's me, Eleanor. I'm so sorry. Mother stopped my heart long enough to sever our bond. Staying near me won't stop you from dying now. Or worse. But I can still help you escape. This little sister's brought you something that will allow you to take control of her.
You know, actually, I'm kind of wondering. So, yeah, we actually had the technology. This is how ahead of the times Rapture was. I don't know if this is Dr. Lamb's invention or Tenenbaum's or somebody else's. I have no idea. I mean, you can look it up on Bioshock Wiki or something to fill in all the details that I never quite understood, but...
Now you can see through her eyes and tell her where to go. This is how I brought you back without Mother catching on. Now, first, let's get you out of here.
But, yeah, Delta is able to somehow send his consciousness into this little sister, and now that I think about it, I mean, through that plasmid, whatever the hell that was, that the little sister injected into me. But I wonder how this would have worked out if I'd actually taken the route of the villain. I mean, would Eleanor have sent a little sister to help me escape, or... Because I imagine the little sisters would not like me too much. Because if I harvested every single one in the joint, they'd be bound to catch on eventually. So yeah, this is what's interesting. This actually isn't... Ah, see, this is the room where we actually fought the big sisters a little while ago. But this actually, you know, of course, this is not actually what the little sister is seeing. This, you know, nice, clean environment with all this, you know, white silk everywhere and nice velvety couches and no dead bodies. Clean water. Stuff like that. You know, this is just what the little sister sees because she's so innocent, I guess. I thought it was kind of fascinating, this part of the game, but yeah, it would have been interesting if you could actually do something to achieve a bad ending. I mean, I don't know, maybe you can because I never took the villain route or anything like that. If it turns out Dr. Lamb, you know, did fully intend to kill her daughter just by suffocating her all the way and actually, you know, just to take out Subject Delta 2 to get her revenge on him for kind of influencing Eleanor over to his side. Because, well, again, you know, I'm the one who's acting like a real father to her, and her mother's just a petty bitch. Would have been a sad ending, but it would have been pretty powerful. I just don't know how it was that Dr. Lamb knew she was able to actually just suffocate Eleanor long enough to stop her heart for just a second without actually killing her, enough to sever the bond between her and Delta, which of course would leave Delta pretty much paralyzed, and somehow or another, I mean, I don't know the reasoning behind it, but I'm sure there is some kind of scientific gobbledygook that maybe Bioshock Wakia would try to explain or something, that somehow Dr. Lamb was confident that I would just die off on my own once I was trapped there enough, I guess, just from being away from Eleanor physically with that bond severed. I don't know. But of course, thanks to me being able to sort of see through a little sister's eyes and guide her movements, we'll take care of that.
You're in. There should be a lever in here somewhere. Pull it, and it will unlock our cells.
Attention! Augustus Sinclair has been sighted within the facility. He will attempt to reach Subject Delta.
Oh, there she is.
Until he is found.
Is So yeah, unfortunately now Dr. Lamb is also after my ally Sinclair. What's she writing? And why is she not paying any attention to me whatsoever? Hey, lady. Yo. Hello. Look at me. I'm little sister. Trying to help the big daddy that you just took prison. I'm totally against you. Okay, I'm on my way to free him right now. If you care. Like, I'm totally going to foil your plans. Okay. She doesn't give a shit.
What Mother did to me left me very weak. Or I would do this part myself.
Well, getting strangled half to death does that to people.
I'm going to have to change to be like you. From here, you should be able to locate the pieces of a big sister suit. Please, bring them to me.
Now, here is a plot hole I really just couldn't get over, and if a bigger Bioshock fan can explain to me in comments later or something. I find it interesting that I could totally just, you know, here I am, like, literally inches away from these splicers right here. Now, they're splicers, of course, but she's just seeing, like, elegant party masks on them instead of their, you know, normal disfigured faces, but... I'm a little sister. They're not coming after me for Adam or anything. I thought that was like their fundamental reason for chasing little sisters. And I mean, even being willing to duke it out with big daddies, you know, much against their better judgment, in order to get at the Adam and the little sister that he's protecting. But yeah, they're just totally ignoring me. I pulled that lever down in front of Dr. Lamb. I mean, I know she was kind of looking in another direction, but it was just feet away, and I figure it had to make some kind of audible noise, and she just did not notice. That does kind of make this part a little weak, in my opinion, but, you know.
Mother says that my condition is a blessing in disguise. She constantly reminds me that I was born for the express purpose of promoting her ideals. And now, she's trying to convince me to begin splicing with the same cocktail that drove Dr. Alexander mad. She thinks that my condition makes me immune to the damage. The surface is my only chance of freedom. Mother took the one person I knew from above and murdered him in front of my eyes. Father, if I could only find a way to bring him back.
Yeah, it's like even a corpse. I mean, a little sister will see it as just kind of like a sleeping, you know, figure that's, I mean, that doesn't look like no wounds, nothing, no ghastly expression in death, and even, you see like the outlying of a halo and wings here. This is what she considers an angel. And instead of flies, you know, buzzing around a carcass, those are, you know, butterflies, a much more aesthetically pleasing insect. Oh. Okay, well, I guess some splicers do pay attention. Can I pick that up? Kind of like that bouncer big daddy doll. And what's this say? Daddy meets Aunt Gracie. Huh. You know, I actually don't think I've noticed this before. I don't know if this is just a coincidence, like maybe this is the name of a play. A famous play that, you know, gets put on in Rapture's, like, entertainment district. Or if this is some message from Eleanor. And she's referring to when Delta, you know, first met with Grace Holloway. You know, when she had Eleanor with her. And of course, as we found out, that was not a very pleasant encounter because he, you know, being a big daddy, he got overprotective and slugged Gracie across the face.
There's a piece of the suit in here, Father. Find the rest and bring them back to me.
So we're finding, like, a big sister suit for Eleanor, and another, you know, minor point, but it's kind of a part of the plot I noticed.
10 years, Father. Stuck in this fever dream. Mother kept me sedated in order to perfect my mind with Adam. To her, the ideal child is a genius, serving the common good without questioning it. You have saved me from that.
Indeed I did, and, these splicers do not question where I'm going with this big sister suit, probably draped over most of my body, like she's probably practically hidden underneath it. Okay, so I was looking at a bunch of, like, gauges and pipes for controlling the water flow, I guess, the steam. And what the little sister was seeing was a big statue of a big daddy, like, I guess he was about to drill a splicer in the face, I don't know. Either that or he was posing some kind of superhero figure helping this guy in some way, because it looks like he's taking him by the arm. And the drill isn't threateningly raised or anything. And the music going on right now, My Heart Belongs to Daddy. Love that song. Yes, I mean, look, right there. I literally gathered Adam up right in front of these guys, and they aren't drawn to me whatsoever. Now, this might be explained somehow in a very, very fine detail I missed. I mean, I admit, I'm not good at picking up on stuff in a lot of games, even after multiple times playing it. But I find it a big plot hole that I just gathered up Adam from this guy, and these splicers are standing just yards away, and they totally don't care. They're not coming after me. I mean, they're staring at me like they know I got Adam on me. But they don't do anything. Anyway, what did the rest of that diary say before Eleanor interrupted? I like how it's almost just an act of vengeance, you know, Eleanor coming up with the plan to revive me. Okay, so I'm carrying all this big sister shit.
Mother was right about one thing. I have been watching you, Father. Studying the way you have treated others. And now I know who I am.
Well, I guess we'll kind of gloss over all those times that I killed splicers. I mean, they are human beings, albeit crazy ones that are...
I am free. After everything Mother has done to me, I'm alive and sane enough to be curious about the sun. When you rescued my new sisters, I felt every one, and it gave me hope for the first time in years.
Okay, Dr. Lamb left her chair. I don't know where she went.
We've done it, Father. I'll be there soon.
Yeah, and now Eleanor's just able to kick so much ass, just like any other big sister. I don't know how.
These suits always did make me think of you, Father. I guess I still remember you in shining armor. But now it's my turn to fight for you.
You mean a dingy, rusted old diving suit? Well, hey, whatever does it for you.
You can use it to call me to your side in a...
Yeah, she's able to do that. Now, the thing with this plasmid is, as awesome as it is, it's just totally broken, in my opinion. I mean, it takes a whole entire, bar of Eve, and so it's basically the, you know, for every Eve hypo you have, you'll be able to use this thing once. But Eleanor stays around for a really long time, and she pretty much kills enemies in one hit. So I'm gonna try to use this sparingly, just to kind of keep the challenge up. Oh, anyway, I do believe that I had a diary from Dr. Lamb I was listening to before the last in-game dialogue.
Eleanor is changing as Delta draws closer. In her sleep, she mutters about having witnessed moments from his journey here. She is beginning to resist the moral conditioning. Eleanor's bond with Delta turning her from the daughter of the people back into a rebellious child whose voice I do not recognize. Worse, I suspect Eleanor of direct involvement in his return. I fear that to separate them, I may have to take measures for which I will be unable to forgive myself.
You know, as much as I talk about how, you know, batshit evil and crazy Dr. Lamb is and her pursuit of goodness, you know, you really can't help but feel sorry for her when you hear, and there's going to be plenty more lines of dialogue like that before the end of the game from her, or you really can't help but feel sorry for her at the same time. I mean, from her perspective, even though she is in the wrong, I am literally taking her child away from her. She even says that, you know, going to the lengths that she does to try to, you know, fool me one last time and almost killing her own daughter, she's not even going to be able to forgive herself, but it's kind of like she's lost everything, you know, with my influence over Eleanor. My showing, you know, the free will to do acts of kindness and all, and that ruins her life's work, and her daughter is estranged from her in just about every way now. So she really has, I mean, I just thought it was a really good effect. The dialogue, the voice acting in this game, and the way things are worded, it really is among the most impressive out of any game I've ever played. I really have to say that. Okay, I'm not gonna really worry about ammo right now. Maybe when I get some more money. I think I pretty much got all my med kits back from when the little sister brought back all the stuff that I gathered up. Yeah, Eleanor just took out a brute splicer on her way to free me from that chamber right there. Eleanor. I mean, she hasn't exactly been doing, like, martial arts training or, you know, some kind of elite military, you know, training whatsoever, and yet you just put a big sister suit on her. In fact, in anything, she should be even more physically unfit than most normal girls her age. She's been, like, in a drunken stupor from, you know, from all the atom conditioning Dr. Lamb's been giving her over the last 10 years. She really shouldn't be at the top of her game. And yet she puts on a big sister diving suit, and she can just pretty much fuck up a brute splicer, no problem. I don't know, I just find that kind of interesting. Oh! Accusations. Just let them fight it out. Hi! Alright, we'll take them both out.
Subject Delta, I know you can hear me. You have stolen my life's work, and with it, my only daughter. But Rapture is the house of monsters. The surface will not have us. And now, we shall be buried as a family, side by side.
That's a really dysfunctional family.
Oh God, she's going to drop this building into the trench. It's miles deep. We have to find Sinclair.
Yeah, that's another problem. Oh, what? Yeah, even though we basically took the good path here, you know, by sparing everybody's life, I know you were supposed to spare Gil's according to this game's messed up moral logic, but, you know, again, I personally did not feel right leaving him alive when he begged me to kill him. But yeah, despite taking the good path, rescuing the little sisters and all that, it is kind of interesting. I mean, Eleanor really has no compunction about killing all the splicers who try to stand in her way. I mean, she'll even say things that almost sound like, you know, every now and then, you'll hear. Of course, they tend to sound even, you know, like more evil and vicious. If you take the bad path, I kind of, you know, I've caught a glimpse of some gameplay while you were, like on YouTube, you know, of you taking the dark path. I imagine, I didn't see it, but, you know, when the little sister that I was guiding came back to Eleanor to put the, give her the big sister suit, I'm guessing if you took the dark path and, harvested all the little sisters, then she probably would have, you know, again, copying your actions, because this whole thing is about your influence over her as a father figure, and she probably would have just, you know, killed the little sister right then and there for actually helping her. Paid her back with death. Probably would have been a pretty upsetting sight, but yeah. Okay, again, I'm not going to worry about trying to gather supplies right now. I didn't use the plasma to summon Eleanor, but this was a point where she was supposed to appear that's going to happen every now and then, so that she can kind of keep the player informed on what's going on. And, you know, and of course you've heard it, Dr. Lamb, she intends to just, you know, have us all die together now. Because, hey, what else? What else are you going to do at this point? Okay, so, we're going to go into the heart of Persephone next and try to do what we can to stop Dr. Lamb from throwing us deeper into the ocean and drowning us all. And we will take care of that in the next episode. Thanks again for watching, guys.